The Philippine National Police on full alert until the end of the year for the holidays, as well as for the upcoming 54th anniversary of the Communist Party of the Philippines. We have with us Philippine National Police spokesperson, Colonel Gene Fajardo. Colonel Gene, good afternoon and thank you so much for joining the program.
Good afternoon, Ma'am Rica.
Merry Christmas to you, Colonel. Now, the holiday season crime rate for the country is actually down by 14%. At least that's some good numbers that we're seeing. What may be contributing factors to this?
We contribute to the continuous downtrend of crime statistics due to our early deployment of PNP personnel, as just like what we did in the last UNDAS, where we recorded a zero incident, and we also make the same early deployment to make sure that the whole Yuletide season will remain peaceful as it is as we speak right now.
Mm-hmm. We have number of 3,000 that's deployed for the holidays. There's a traveler influx happening now, not just in the airport, but also in the ports, not just in the airport, but also in bus terminals and other transport hubs. How does the PNP coordinate with traffic agencies for road safety in both national and local routes, Colonel?
Yes, as early as first week of December, we already coordinated with, particularly in National Capital Region, with the MMDA and LTO in anticipation of the influx of people traveling in and out of Metro Manila. That is why we also increased our PNP deployment to help the traffic enforcers manage and control traffic, particularly in gridlock areas where there are some road construction, and also in anticipation of the extended mall hours and activities in night market. And we also established our police assistance desk to make sure that our kababayans will have easy coordinating with us in case there are some security and safety concerns. There are police officers manning all areas of convergence.
Mm-hmm. That is for the Metro, Colonel Gene. But what about for the provinces? Are we also looking at the Metro provinces for convergence of more people? Or what of those who doesn't have that much population?
We are doing the same security framework, Ms. Rica, with the other areas here in the Philippines. And that is why even in the provincial terminals, we are also deploying our PNP personnel as early as the first week of December. In fact, we are also deploying some bus marshal in areas where we recorded some incidents before. Mm-hmm. And aside from that, we also deployed our explosive and or explosive and narcotics detection dogs to make sure that no illegal contrabands will pass through our major transport terminals and hubs, and in order to at least make sure that our travelers will be safe while they are on travel.
Mm, so it seems, Colonel Gene, that not just all hands, but even all paws are on deck for the holidays. We are on full alert up until December 31st. The anniversary of the Communist Party is happening tomorrow. There's no declaration of ceasefire from them. What is the PNP expecting, and how are we prepared for any event?
In the same like in previous years, Ms. Rica, we already anticipated this date. That's why this is also included in our security deployment, and our PNP station, particularly those located in vulnerable areas, were intensified by deploying mobile forces and some personnel of Special Action Force to make sure that we can prevent any atrocities and harassment in anticipation of the December 26 CPP anniversary and, of course, the death of Kadjo Masipa.
Mm-hmm. There's a leadership vacuum in the Communist Party, Colonel Gene. Is the PNP optimistic that the movement will die down? Or has there been more rebels reaching out to the government since Joma season passed?
We want to look at in a positive perspective, Ms. Rica, that the death of Kadjo Masipa will open a new era in terms of our call for peace. And hopefully whoever will replace Kadjo Masipa in the leadership of CPP will consider embracing our call for peace, and all others, all other members of the Communist Terrorist Group will consider this new development to at least have an open heart to consider the call for peace and justice. And we this is the proper time for us Filipinos to embrace the call of justice, the call of peace, and the five decades of insurgency has not provided all those members of communist terrorist group a better life compared to the call and offer of the PL, or offer of the government to have a better life, not only for them, but for the rest of their families as well.
Mm-hmm. All right, with that, I will let you go. Colonel Gene Fajardo, you have a Merry Christmas ahead, Colonel, and thank you so much for your time.
Thank you, Ms. Rica.